We could all use some healing these days, so we turn to the power of music. Each Monday, we welcome another artist to share some songs and stories as the Nicole Sandler Show presents the Monday Music Sunset Sessions.
And today we welcome Jonathan Brook to the show. Ah, Jonathan, I see you, and you're in your kitchen where you've been doing these COVID kitchen concerts since the quarantining began. First, hello and thank you. Welcome to the show.
Hi, thank you. Can you hear me?
I hear you. There you are. What a treat.
Wait,
this
I can't
is.
See you.
No, I know. I'm sorry you can't see me because the camera is being used to go out to YouTube. So it's only a one-way thing.
Okay.
I did tell you that.
And I lied. I'm not in my kitchen. I came upstairs to my room because it's quieter because someone started mowing their lawn.
Oh, I see. So. I see. You don't have all the blankets around to muffle the sound from your
no
COVID
teddy bear,
kitchen
no
concert.
Quilts.
No, and the teddy bear with Black Lives Matter face mask on and everything. But people can see your kitchen if they go to your Facebook Live page, and you do this every Monday. You've been doing it for, what, 12 weeks now?
Yeah. Yeah. It's flown by. I guess that's about 3 months. I mean, I've been quarantined for about 3 months, so I might as well do a concert every week. And it's become my world tour, like, because there are people tuning in from all over the world, and it's kind of exciting to see who's calling from where.
It is amazing. And problems such as the coronavirus make people get very creative in ways to socialize, in ways to entertain, in ways to make money. You know, I've been doing my show from my home studio for a decade or more now, so it really wasn't that much of a change for me. But I'm loving seeing artists like you just do these concerts online, and this is right now replacing touring for you because that's basically your bread and butter, isn't it?
It really is. I mean, in the course of like a couple of weeks, our entire year was just decimated. Everything got canceled. So the only thing we could do was like, okay, what do we do now? I love playing, so let's just do it from my kitchen. And then people would complain, oh, the sound's not good enough yet. You need to do some sound baffling and stuff. Like each week it would get better and better. I get a better
the blankets
mic,
showed
the quilts up. I got the teddy bear. And then I got really used to it. I sort of started liking this sort of intimacy, basically with my toaster oven, but also reaching people that I hadn't seen in years, you know, in Germany and Belgium and Australia. It's really been cool.
Yeah, it is so cool. And I'll tell you, when the quarantining first started, I happened upon a Facebook group called View From My Window, where people were posting pictures of the view that they see out their window, from all over the world. And I reached out to a number of them and I brought them on the show. I spoke to people in Germany and Denmark and Australia, New Zealand. And I mean, you name it. It's been really wonderful just connecting with people all over the world, realizing we're all going through this together. This is the first time I know of that we've all experienced the same thing in a similar manner around the world.
Yeah. It really does give you a sense of community and, you know, how the world is enormous, but it's so tiny too. And on the one hand, it makes it just this awesome little cozy place in your internet world. And on the other hand, it sort of makes you miss them even more and wait, you know, can't wait to get back out there and actually tour in person.
Well, we can't wait to see you in person, but this is the next best thing. So Jonathan Brook is with us. You're there. You're now living in Minnesota. When did you move to Minnesota? And are you in Minneapolis?
We're in Minneapolis.
Oh, boy. Wow.
Yep. We are about a mile and a half from where George Floyd was killed.
Wow.
Yeah, it's intense, but I think there's a lot of amazing conversations going on. There's a lot of good work being done. There are a lot of amazing people rising to this occasion and having conversations that are hard. And it's underneath. It's a really good city that I think has a lot of potential to be better. But I think there are a lot of people doing the hard work, which is awesome.
There most definitely are.
And everywhere. And I think it's inspired the world.
Yeah, Oh, it most definitely has. All you have to do is see people marching in countries you would never expect. I mean, France,
yeah,
and Italy, and Australia, and you name it. And it's about time. So, you know, good that, you know, I feel just horrible for George Floyd's little girl, but so glad that she knows her daddy's changing the world. And he certainly is. Yeah. You know, you're going to play a couple of songs for us, or a few songs for us, I hope. I have here, you know, last week you did you're doing your kitchen COVID concerts every Monday, 2 p.m. Central Time, Minneapolis time. And last week you did your album Plum from start to finish, which is very cool. But you posted a picture of it and you're like, this is not even the correct album cover. You said it was like a mistake. The wrong one was set. And so I went looking through my CD collection, which I'm now starting to purge. And I found I also have the wrong CD cover. But
amazing.
Yeah, but I've got a bunch of Jonathan Brooks CDs here, and what I'm going to do, because I've digitized everything and I'm cleaning everything out, the first 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 people who email me, Nicole@NicoleSandler.com, with your address telling me you want one of Jonathan's CDs, I will send them to you as a little prize from today's show.
That's nice.
Yeah. So, Jonathan, what are you going to do for us? I know I have one request for you, but the others I'll leave.
Yes, my request. I was going to do one of my older songs, but it's probably the most beloved, especially from 20 whatever years ago.
Yes.
You know, when we were 12.
Yes,
like,
we were
back
in that video.
Was it Cancun or Turks and Caicos?
That was Cancun. Yeah. Oh my!
I love how on the video it says, like, by the time this thing airs, and I'm like, we might be in our 50s.
60. I'm 60 now.
No way.
Yes.
Quit it.
I turned 60 in November, so I'm officially old. But, you know, hey, music keeps you young.
Yeah.
I don't care. Whatever.
I think it's getting better. I think it's just getting better.
Yeah. So this is the song you're going to start with. I got to tell you, when we first met, this song always made me cry. And I've always said that a sign of a truly great song is when it can elicit a physical reaction from you, whether it be goosebumps or tears. When a song can do that to you, and a song continues to do that after 20 some odd years. And you played it for me. We were in the FM 101.9 Music Hall at KSEA in Los Angeles, and you played the song, and I think I started crying. And you said, why does that
yes,
and it was before I had a kid. And I said, because I could just feel it. And I'm telling you, this song called So Much Mine is... it's a mother singing to her daughter. And then you met Allison. It was just a couple of months after I adopted her. We were in Cancun together. And she just turned 21 last month. And
oh, my God.
Yes. Do you believe it? Little Allison is now 21. And this song still, thankfully, she didn't get the worst of me. But there are still so many things that I see in her. And all I think is, she's so much mine. She is so much mine. And your song has stayed with me through all these years. It is one of my all-time favorite songs. So thank you for doing this for us.
My pleasure. Here we go. It is a mother-daughter lament, really. Here we go. Bold eyes. I know that it's
please don't go. So much mine. Now I reach for you and I cannot find you. So much, so much mine. Now I reach for you and I cannot find you.
Wow, Jonathan Brook, So Much Mine, a song found on the album The Angel in the House, but the artist is The Story. That was the band that Jonathan was in when I first heard of her, Jonathan Brook and Jennifer Kimball, and then you guys, not too long after that, split up, you went solo, and your next album was Jonathan Brook and The Story, right?
Yeah, it was Plum.
That was Plum, wow, so we plumbed the depth there, going way back, and then it
plumbing
just
the depth.
Yes, and then became Jonathan Brook, and you've been going strong ever since. So you were living in New York, weren't you? And then you moved to Minneapolis.
Yeah, we moved to Minneapolis about 3 years ago, in the winter.
Oh!
not something I would recommend, because the spring and the summer and fall are actually gorgeous, gorgeous, amazing. The winters are, you know, they're intense, but I'm from Boston, so I wasn't too afraid. You know, it's pretty cold there too, and I do love the snow. So you know, it's beautiful. It's just you gotta plan ahead. You know, if you leave the house when it's 12 below, really plan ahead.
Yeah. Well, you know, we're in Florida, so we don't even go there now.
Oh my God!
Now, you've got a new album coming out July 10th. It's called The Sweetwater Sessions. Where's Sweetwater?
Sweetwater is this amazing recording studio that is connected to the Sweetwater, I guess it's like basically the Amazon of the music business. Sweetwater is a mail-away musical supply warehouse, basically.
Oh, so okay, I do know
anything.
Of Sweetwater, right?
Yeah, and they have a beautiful world-class studio that's connected to their other business. So they've sort of been feeding both things at once, and so it's become a destination for musicians to go there and make records and or go to recording workshops, which is I've been partnering on some of those recording workshops, and that's how this whole record got started. Was I was part of teaching a recording workshop, and we just decided, well, why don't we just stay a couple extra days and we'll make a record, because we got these musicians in this studio and all this stuff on the shelves. Like, if we want a bass ukulele, we can just sort of call it in from the store, so we could try whatever we wanted. And so that's what we did. We ended up tracking 11 songs, sort of tracking them at the tail end of this recording workshop, and it turned into this great romp through my catalog. It's 11 songs, basically favorites of mine that didn't necessarily get a lot of attention at the time that they came out. So it's sort of, I chose a song from each record.
Oh, how nice. Oh, that's awesome. Yeah. So that's out July 10th, I'm guessing, from all the usual places. So you can get the record without ever leaving your home.
You can stream it. There are two singles, actually, that are already streaming on all of the, whatever those places are, Spotify, Hookie Lookie, Pandora,
right?
Shebangalang.
Apple Music,
It's streaming the first two songs, and then the rest is coming out July 10th. Or you can pre-order it on my website, and I will sign it for you.
Nice. And the website, of course, is jonathabrook.com. And yes, it's like Jonathan without the N at the end. Were your parents expecting a boy?
No, that's the weird part. I have two older brothers, so I hope they were hoping for a girl, because I think two boys is probably plenty.
Yeah.
And I came along and I don't know, they saddled me. I used to hate my name because I'd have to explain it to everybody, but now I really do appreciate it.
Cool, and it's unique to you. So it's Jonathan, like Jonathan without the N, and Brooke with an E on the end, jonathabrooke.com. Mm-hmm. And you're, you know, in addition, I'm so impressed with what you're doing. I mean, again, we all have to get creative these days to figure out how to get things done, and you are an amazing songwriter. You've done something. You've started a series called The Master Classes. What is this? What are you doing?
What am I doing? Like, well, I have begun teaching in the past bunch of years, and I love it. It's turned into a real passion of mine. So I've done these songwriting workshops. A lot of them happen in Nashville. And because I can't be doing this in person right now, and I just did a bunch in Denmark, actually, when I was on tour there last fall. So I figured, all right, well, this may or may not happen. I had some scheduled in the fall, and we're hoping that we can make those things happen. But in the meantime, maybe this is another silver lining of this COVID hell. And I can do some teaching online to people that maybe would never make it to Nashville. I mean, the one woman came from the Philippines to one of my Zoom classes, and another woman in Australia, it was 3 a.m. for her. Poor thing. She had to stay awake, but it was awesome. And then there was a woman in Germany last weekend, and it's been really, really exciting to be able to reach that much further afield and sort of give all this stuff that I love telling people about songwriting.
Nice. Well, that's great. Now, I noticed it said sold out. So are there going to be more of these?
Well, that's something I was sort of talking in my kitchen COVID concert today. Uh-huh. I was saying, like, yeah, they're pretty much all sold out. So let me know if this has been a good thing for you, and maybe we could do some more. So I think depending on, and actually from the news that you were talking about earlier, where like COVID cases are just ballooning and out of control because of, like, duh, we haven't been social distancing and all these states are opening up. So I have a feeling that I'm going to have to open up some more masterclasses because I think we're not going to be going anywhere anytime soon.
Right. I think so. Jonathan Brooke is with us. You can do another song?
Okay.
Okay. So what are you going to do next? You want to do one of the new ones?
Put the Gun Down.
Oh. I heard you play that today. I was listening to some of your songs in preparation for you coming. And what is this from, an album of yours? Where is this from?
This is from an album 2 albums ago called Midnight Hallelujah.
Okay.
That I also actually made at the Sweetwater Studios. We have a history. We go way back.
Cool. So Put the Gun Down, obviously, it's, you know, topical.
Obviously,
today.
The title. It's pretty clear what's it about.
Absolutely.
Here we go. It's sticky up here in the attic today. Whew. Put the gun down and come talk to me. You got a lot of nerve. You're bitching about your prophets, Italian laws, and then you carry on, carry on, carry on. You carry on, carry on, carry on. Nobody done you wrong. So you carry on, and you put the gun down. Keeping you clean, or is it just attention that you crave? Put the gun down. Nobody has to lose. You got no way out except forgiveness. So you better choose. Then you carry on. Carry on, carry on, carry on.
But it's Tuesday, you could make it to Wednesday. Thursday, you might feel the sun. Friday, knows nothing about Saturday. A Sunday, don't need no gun. So don't aim, don't swing. Carry on, carry on, carry on. Carry on, carry on, carry on. No matter done you wrong, just carry on. You carry on, carry on, carry on. You carry on, carry on, carry on. No matter done you wrong, you carry on. Gun down. Yeah, you put the gun down.
Yeah, Jonathan Brook, put the gun down. Here on the Nicole Sandler Show, Monday Music. How do you get your inspiration? Do you ever write songs based on what's happening around us, the news, or are they more personal, you know, so much mind stories about life, about your family, about your everyday experience rather than social issues?
It's a little of both, but I think when it's a social issue, like for instance, guns, I'm more comfortable telling a smaller story that will like poke at the issue, but not be try to be a soapbox or an anthem. So in the case of that song, it was like, it's just a conversation between me and a person with a gun. Mm-hmm. And it's so interesting that you were saying earlier that the Supreme Court declined to hear all of the Second Amendment cases.
Yeah. Interesting, so interesting, huh?
Mm-hmm. But political, yes, once in a while. I wrote a song called War, which is actually on the Plum record, that was definitely a reaction and a more anthemic kind of statement about the Gulf War, the first Gulf War. Uh-huh. And, you know, obviously it's really appropriate now, but I mean, because I'm talking about the flag and patriotism, and we hold these truths to be self-evident, and we're the boss, and we're the United States. You have to do what we'll say,
right?
So that song is holding its weight actually after 20 years. For the most part, I like to just tell smaller stories, mm-hmm. and they aren't necessarily about me. Or if they are about me, I totally embellish because I think lying is way sometimes more interesting than the truth. Well, I tell all my songwriting students, like, don't tell the truth. It's not three chords in the truth. It's lots more chords and totally make shit up.
Right. It's storytelling. It is. It's about telling the stories and doing it with a beautiful melody and weaving us in and out. And you do it. You do it beautifully. Now, I got to ask you. So, Jonathan Brook, I'm watching today's COVID Kitchen concert. Again, 2 Central Time on Mondays on Jonathan's Facebook Live. And you were talking about your show. My Mother Has 4 Noses. Tell us. What? Tell me about this. It's an off-Broadway show?
Yes. Briefly, I made an off-Broadway show. I made a one-woman musical about my last 2 years caring for my mother. My mom was a character. It was a story that you wouldn't believe unless I told it, and it felt urgent and important at the time, and it still does because there are so many things that people are afraid to talk about. My mother had dementia. Caregiving is hell. Helping somebody move on to their next phase, you know, through their late stages and then death. It's a big task and it's sacred work. So I ended up writing this musical about it. And so I weave the story of me and my mother through 10 songs, and I premiered it off Broadway in 2014 and got amazing, amazing reviews. So I've since been able to do it in many cities around the country.
Wow.
Cleveland and Minneapolis. I did a month run last year in Minneapolis, Arkansas, Philadelphia, at people's light. So it's really touched a nerve, and it's a sort of universal story of unconditional love and caregiving and the humor and the pathos and the tragedy that all combined together in that swirl of love, of caring for someone that you love.
Wow, that sounds amazing. Is there an album of this? Have you recorded it?
There is an album of the 10 songs that are part of the show. It's a beautiful record. It's a Jonathan record, but it happens to be the songs that are in the show, because we didn't do like a cast album, you know, with the dialogue
right.
and the songs.
Gotcha.
The songs.
Right.
But I'm trying to figure out a way to produce that in this new normal.
Right.
How do I present that show from my kitchen, maybe? So I'm toying with ways of presenting that, because I feel like it's such a pressing conversation. Especially now, like so many people in long-term facilities and elder care facilities are at the front lines of this epidemic.
And what's happening now is just horrific.
Yeah.
It is so sad, because, you know, people may place their parents in a care facility thinking, all right, they're going to get the care they need here. But now with the COVID, you can't even visit your elderly parents. I mean, and many of them are getting sick and dying alone. And dying has got to be scary enough, but to do it alone without your family around you, what our seniors are going through right now is just horrible. And the fact that
you add dementia to the mix.
Oh, God.
And that terror and confusion of like not understanding what's happening, of not understanding who these people are, why you're alone, why you can't go home. It's just, my heart just crumbles daily when I see these stories.
I can't even imagine.
Seems apropos.
Yes, definitely. Well, that's something on a lot of our minds. I mean, I lost my parents years ago. So, you know, I guess that's the silver lining, is I don't have to worry about them now. I can't even imagine what people are going through whose parents they cannot get to. It's the other end of the So Much Mind story. It's like you want to be there. So, Jonathan Brook, we're getting close to the end of the hour. I'm going to ask you to do one more song, but I'm going to let our friends at Progressive Voices know that Jonathan will play us out. Just a quick promo for next Monday. You're familiar with The Immediate Family? The immediate family is Russ Kunkel, Waddy Wachtel, Leland Sklar, Danny Korchmar, and Steve Postel. These are like legendary sidemen who've worked with everybody from Carole King to James Taylor to Warren Zevon and on and on and on. And now they're together. They finally are doing their own thing, and their new album is just about to premiere, and they're going to join us next Monday for the Monday Music Show. So, I'm excited about that one too. So just wanted to let people know. So what are you going to play us out with, Jonathan Brook?
Well, I'm going to play a song called Twilight, because I love it.
Okay, that's a good reason.
And it's kind of about making your peace with things before it's too late, and telling people that you love them and apologizing before it's too late.
That works for right now, too.
Yeah, and stop me if I go over, okay?
Oh, no, you can go over. We'll get cut off on Progressive Voices, so we'll say goodbye to the Progressive Voices Network now, but we can keep going, because
we
can do that.
Great,
yeah.
So I won't try to
keep going.
Great.
No.
Okay,
all right.
Here we go.
Jonathan Brook.
Tell me something sweet that I'll remember. Look me in the eye when twilight comes. Hold me. September, loving as my light fades into December. We can pick a sign, a secret signal, simple by design, so we'll both know. Maybe a shooting star off Jupiter, her in a wishing well, or a puppet in the rain. I love you, not perfectly, not well, but I love you, and I'm leaving soon. So let that be the story that you tell. Maybe now's the time to ask forgiveness. I will beg for yours and I'll leave you mine. Weaving a tapestry of things unspoken, we'll lay it down at the feet of all the promises we've broken. Yeah, take from me my best, how I adore you, and leave behind the liar and the cheat, and promise the kindness is the legacy you'll carry like a hand-me-down until we meet again. I love you, not perfectly, not well, but I love you, and I'm leaving soon, so fare thee well. I love you, so let that be the story that you tell. No one sees it coming, we run away, we hide away, we never say, but love keeps humming. Today, 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 not well, but I love you, and I'm leaving soon, so fare thee well. I love you, I love you, so let that be the story that you tell. Tell me something sweet that I'll remember. Look me in the eye when twilight comes.
That was beautiful. Jonathan Brook.
Having puberty in my voice all over again.
Well, you know, this is your second show of the day. So, you know, the late show. I appreciate it.
It's the late show.
It's the late show. It's the sunsets. And here, well, I'd say it's sunset, but it's raining again as usual in Florida. So not much sun here.
It's gorgeous here, I have to say.
And you can't really get out and enjoy it, can you?
Well, we can. There's we live about a 10-minute walk from a beautiful lake, Lake Harriet. So we can walk around Lake Harriet and be socially distant. We wear our masks and we stay away from sweaty, spitty people.
Glad to hear it, as you should. We all need to. We're going to have plenty of time to go back out again. Look, I wanted to go to the beach this weekend. And there are beaches around here that are quiet. But you know what? We'll wait. Better to be safe.
Yeah, it's just it's such a weird thing. I mean, yes, okay, we have to get back to real life, but you know, at what cost?
Right. That's it. And it's you got to stay safe. That's the thing. I mean, I don't understand people going out and partying. And we knew it. We're seeing these numbers spike 2 weeks after Memorial Day. And you know, they say the incubation period is about 14 days, and sure enough, that's what's happening. All right, well, we are just about out of time. Jonathan Brook, what a treat this has been for me. I can't thank you enough.
Oh, my pleasure.
Really can't thank
you
enough.
So great to see you again.
And you as well. Thank you. The new album, again, will be out on July 10th. It is called The Sweetwater Sessions. It's available now for pre-order wherever you get those records these days.
Stuff.
Anywhere you get them, it's there. And we will keep an eye out for My Mother Has Four Noses, off-Broadway, wherever we may be. Jonathan Brook, what a treat this has been. Thank you so much.
Thank you, Nicole.
Take care. Great to see you again. Bye-bye.
You too. Bye.
All right. Tomorrow on the program, it is Tuesday. Gotta Laugh will be here. We'll get back to news and, you know, all the depressing stuff of the day. Thank you for listening, everyone. We'll see you tomorrow. Bye.